pressure that they're holding on to, you're going to see them, their feet digging into the sand in order to kind of stay in position and keep their kites flying. So definitely be watching the sky. And also want to watch the pilots. So you're going to see three pilots that are down on the northeast corner of the field. That's the field right by the edge, right by the river there. They're kind of getting coordinated with their efforts because, of course, you've got all these lines and you don't want to get tangled. And so we've got flying these stacks. Russell, Connor, Dorn, and Brett Morris are going to be flying these as soon as they kind of get their things together. After that, on deck, all right, and once again, remember too, to while we're waiting for our next demo fly, to take some time and glance over, and at some point you certainly want to avail yourself of the opportunity to walk around the big kite field and look at these beautiful creations of these big kites, from the whales to the squid, even some of the bowls on the ground, and the crabs on the ground. You're going to be seeing more and more of those go up. Looks like they're starting to move in position, so we're going to start getting close to them. And at one point, between our next break, I will talk a little bit about some of these slip kites and some of these big kites and how they fly and how they get up in the air, and how they're actually anchored into the sand so that they can get enough of that pressure to hold those kites in water. So once again, what you're seeing is we put in a position here. Eli, Connor, and Brett are stack kites. Now, these are going to be fun to watch as the day goes on. We have a variety of different flyers that fly stacks and they fly to music, as you'll experience shortly. And in the process of doing that, as you add flyers, it gets to be really a beautiful, beautiful thing to watch in the sky. So we want to make sure that we're ready to give them a great round of applause. And when they're ready, we're going to be looking for somebody to kind of give us a stomp of the leg. They're not quite ready yet. We have a little bit of shifting winds, and to be honest, the winds are a little bit gusty for stacks. That's one of the reasons why we're getting the rotors for them, so that we have a chance to see them in the sky. But you can already see how much effort he's put into keeping himself on the ground, much less the kites in the air as they get themselves seeing sky surfing there a little bit in there. And so again, they're kind of getting their kites up in position, testing the winds. We do have a little shifting wind already this morning, so they're getting themselves ready soon. Again, just a reminder that we're really grateful for all the support here in Lincoln City. Schmidt Winds Casino Resort, the Family Promise of Lincoln County, Kiwanis Club of Lincoln City, Christie's Food Truck, and many, many more. We'll be thanking them throughout our time together. So, I'm told that they're ready down on the field. All right, so let's get ready for Eli, Connor, and Brett on the stacks.
I'm just like the river, baby. pulling it against the kite.
Comuna Latina, ¿cómo están? Buenos días. Si tenemos una comuna grande latina presente en este momento, por favor, demuéstralo. Un gran aplauso para la comuna latina. Quiero escuchar de ustedes. ¿Qué les parece el festival? Está bonito, ¿no? Como prometimos el año pasado, como nos encontramos con tanta gente de Latinoamérica, de todos lados, que también íbamos a hacer anuncios en español. El segundo locutor en español, me llamo Ron Vivian, y mucho gusto de estar con ustedes de nuevo. Y bueno, vamos a hacer anuncios en español de lo que está pasando durante el festival, pero primero que todo quiero hablar de la seguridad del público, que ya lo hemos dicho muchas veces en inglés, pero lo vamos a traducir ahora en español, por favor. Los perímetros, especialmente, por favor no entren a los sitios de escenario. No podemos poner barreras de metal como en otros festivales y otros eventos para permitir que la gente no entre. Se dan cuenta que solamente tenemos cintas nada más con banderines, pero eso significa, perdón, que no se puede entrar en ese sitio. Por favor, para la seguridad, porque a pesar de que todo se ve muy simpático, muy bonito, muy colorido, hay líneas que son muy peligrosas, especialmente para los niños. Tienen mucho filo, se pueden cortar las piernas, los brazos. Les pido lo mismo aquí en el escenario donde están todos los cometas de arte y grande, a pesar que se ve todo muy inocente, y arriba en el cielo hay asuntos en la arena que son peligrosos para la gente, especialmente para los niños. Vamos a estar aquí todo el día pendiente también de pérdidas. Eso quiere decir, por ejemplo, billeteras, tarjetas de crédito, teléfonos celulares, pertenencias particulares de la gente. Si la pierden, alguien, por favor, si encuentran algo en la arena, tráiganla aquí al escenario principal, por favor, para hacer el anuncio que la tenemos. La otra cosa importante son niños, niños perdidos, que a veces aparecen. Si hay un niño, por ustedes encuentran un niño perdido sin los padres, por favor, si lo pueden ayudar aquí, al escenario principal, para hacer anuncios a los padres que lo vengan a buscar. Mientras tanto, voy a pasar al locutor principal, porque tenemos una rutina. Yo voy a volver de vuelta con anuncios un poco más rato. Muchas gracias, diviértanse.
Wonderful, thank you so much, Ron. We're so glad to be able to help everyone feel comfortable and welcome here. So glad to have you here. So, we are about ready to have another kite flyer on the field. And he is going to be flying what's called a dual line, meaning there's two lines on this sport kite. And I want you to watch some of the incredible maneuvers that Paul de Bakker can make on his flight. And give us a shake of the leg when you're ready, Paul.
I'm just going to add real quick, Paul is flying a kite called the Jinx, which is designed and made by him. So. I hope you can appreciate the craftsmanship when you see his maneuvers. Oh, that's right. Paul was also the engineer of the legs for the... he built them. Okay.
All right, here we go. A warm welcome to Paul de Bakker from Oak Harbor, Washington. In 2018, he came in second place at the World Sport Kite Championship in Malaysia. Many of our flyers here fly all over the world and have great, great experience. So one more time, a great round of applause for Paul DeBacher. We'll be seeing him again soon.
So we're going to be having on deck now Team Kite Life. Now, what you're going to be seeing in a moment is a flyers, flyers, as you see that moving on in the field. Before I do that, though, I want to mention that we found, I think it was found on the pavilion up here, we found a set of car keys. One of them is to a Chevy, probably. One of the keys has a yellow rubber. They're going to be up here near the announcer's booth if you lost a set of keys. So, this is Team Kite Life, and so we haven't seen this before today. This is the first team fly, and what typically happens is one of the flyers, I think is John. John, you're going to be, John Barresi, going to be basically, he's going to be calling the performance. So he has a radio, and he'll be communicating to other members of the team every move so that they go in unison. Now, sometimes they don't even need the practice so often. Sometimes they don't really need the caller, but most of the time we do. A little bit later in the day, we will actually hopefully have them be able to put on the little sound system what your callers are doing. So I think. Music, and if they give me a line or something, all right. So the whole team pulls the lights off. A big round of applause for Team Kite Life.
Thank you. Okay.
Great round of applause. Great round of applause for Team Kite Life.